Add an event to my calendar.
What's the title of the event?
Finish this video.
Okay, when is the event?
10:30 a.m. today.
All right, finish this video today at 10:30 a.m. Do you want to save that?
Yes. All right, now if you're like me, you have an iPhone, and one of the most frustrating things out there today is that didn't get added to your iOS calendar. So I'm going to show you how to synchronize your calendars between the two. Now, what I'll tell you right off the bat, this isn't perfect, but it is a synchronization in terms of that created event right there. So let's get going. First things first, this is really simple if you're comfortable switching iPhone apps or basically applications to manage your events, because I have Google Calendar at the top there, and as long as I've signed into that very same account, when I come in, there's my finish this video event. I can go in and I can see, and it has pre-set up settings, so you could use 30 minutes before as a reminder, and also 30 minutes before as an email reminder. And those are base settings that you can set in Google Calendar. So if you just switch calendars, you're done. But if you don't want to switch calendars, hey, I understand that. Now, most people, what they'll tell you to do is simply import your iOS calendar into Google Calendar and import your Google Calendar into the iOS Calendar application. So I could show you how to do that, but that's not synchronization. So let's talk about what this synchronization looks like before going through the setup. Now, this synchronization, what I'll tell you, you saw me add an event here on my Google Home. After that point, you really can't do anything with Google Home beyond adding more events. You can't manage the events as of yet, so you can't edit those events. You can ask for details about your events today, and on these smart displays, you can actually physically see those events and what you have to complete today and your upcoming events. So, you know, there is the ability to see the events or hear what those events are about, but you cannot modify or delete them. After that, after you've added an event, you have to go ahead and you have to manage through an application. So pick your application, and then at that point, you're going to just create basically a synchronization in what's called the if this then that service. So let's go into that application right now. So IFTTT, this is a website. You can do this on ifttt.com, or you can have the application and then go ahead, create an account. And what you're going to do is you're going to synchronize both your iPhone calendar and your Google Calendar. And I'm going to show you how you go about and do that. So inside of the My Applets section in the application here, you can actually hit the plus up top. And you can see I already have what's called an applet here created that syncs my new events from a Google Calendar to my iOS calendar. Now, I'm going to show you how to create your own. So when I hit that plus up in the top right, I hit if this, and now I can search for the different services. So because we're using the Google Calendar to add an event when we use our Google Home, that's what I'm going to search for, is Google and then Calendar, and you can see that right there. Now, if you haven't already connected your Google account, you will have a button right here. So I'm not going to show you how to physically connect that event. I've already done it, but you just simply tap on that and log in with your Google credentials. And that has to be the same account that you're using to create events. So it has to be the same account as is on your Google Home product. Now, you can see that there are a number of triggers here. So whenever a new event is added, we can trigger something else to happen. So we're going to go ahead and hit new event is added. And now I can pick my calendar. So if you had shared calendars on here, you could also choose those. Now, I'm just choosing my base calendar and I'm hitting create trigger. So every time we create a new event on that calendar, then what do we want to have happen? So the same thing here, we want to go to our iOS calendar. And again, as I tap in here, we want it to we want it to be linked. Now, if you actually download the application on your iPhone here, this is a pretty easy linking action. You're basically hitting that and it's linking to your account here on your iPhone. So that's what I'd suggest for those of you setting this up on an iPhone. Use the iOS application. Now, you go ahead and you create a calendar event as the trigger. So we're inside that next part here where you're creating that calendar event. And you have to choose which calendar you want to put it in. You could choose from all the different iOS calendars that you have integrated inside your iOS calendar, but I'm just choosing the default. So go ahead, choose whatever calendar you want there. Now, the event title, you could add different ingredients. So if you had a description, if you had a place where that you wanted to put that in, you could go ahead and put that, right? The location, hit add ingredient and choose where. So that will tell you where you're going here in your iOS calendar. In terms of a start date, I've already added the starts ingredient. So you're just going to hit add ingredient, hit starts and hit insert again. And that allows you to basically set that start date, set the location, set the title, all coming from your Google Calendar. So all coming from what you put in using your voice here. Now, you can't put in the location just yet with Google, but when that happens and when you can put that in, then it will transfer across for you. A couple more things to set up here. A duration in minutes, it defaults to 60 minutes, but you could put in any duration you'd like, but that will apply to everything you add with your voice on your Google Home device or Google Assistant enabled. In terms of notes, your title starts at starts, and if you wanted, you could add additional ingredients. So you could say where, and let's say you wanted to also know the URL. If you were able to add those again with your voice, they would be there. So all of that is in the notes, and here's the event URL. I've added that as an ingredient here to my URL, and then the alert timing. Now, that's one of the biggest things for me. You can set whatever alert timing you'd like in terms of every event that you add to your Google Home. So 50 minutes generally works for people, but if you wanted to have it 30 minutes all the time, you could, and you can leave it blank for getting no alerts. So once we hit create action now, we have a new applet basically ready to go, and it says if any new event is created on that calendar, then create a calendar event in my iOS application. So you can also at the bottom hit receive notifications when this applet runs, and then you can hit finish. Now, I've told you I've already set one of those up. There was already one here that is running. So now what I'll tell you is this one that I've used, and you can see it was by a gentleman named Alexander, and it runs about every 15 to 20 minutes. So after you've added an event, you can wait up to 15 or 20 minutes to have that synchronized to your iOS calendar. So let me show you in my iOS calendar right now. I still don't have that event from my Google Calendar. Now I'm going to use this check now button down here at the bottom to trigger that movement across, but it will happen naturally anyway. So I'm just hitting check now, and you'll notice a notification come in from the top of the screen. So there it is, and it says now it's syncing new events added from a Google Calendar. So let's go over. There you have it. So now you can see both events actually. So this is on my calendar to finish this video. You can see the event URL has actually come from Google's calendar service. And here you go. This is actually from my Google Calendar. So I had already put that calendar into my iOS so that I could see that all the time. So it shows up as two events. Now, as I said, you could either keep your calendar out from Google Calendar. You don't necessarily need to show that in your iOS account. And so that's down here in calendars, and I can go ahead and I can remove that, hit done. And now I'm just seeing the one event from my Google Calendar here, or from my iOS calendar rather. So you do have this synchronization functionality. The piece that everyone's not going to like, I know that's how it's going to be received, When you delete the event in iOS, it will not delete in Google Calendar and vice versa. So this is where you need to decide which calendar application you're going to use. I could use this one and go ahead and just delete this event, and then I'm managed. But what I would suggest for you is that you do switch over to Google Calendar in general, and you can see now I have three events here because it's been synchronizing across some other applets I have. But what you would do then is you would not show your other calendar. So I'm always going to show my base calendar, but not this one, and not my iOS calendar as well. So that gets rid of them, and then I'm only managing one now. So this is the one that I originally put on here. So yes, we can synchronize. Yes, you can use your iOS calendar, and if you don't install the Google Calendar application, then you know you have it, here it is, it's good. But what will happen if you delete this event from your iOS calendar, that event will still exist here on the Google Home, and it will still show up on your smart displays as well as a notification card. So you have to keep that in mind.
There's one entry tomorrow. At 9 a.m., you have Meet Madeline. All right, it's deleted. There's one entry on Thursday. At 8 p.m., you have Meet Alan.
Delete it.
Sure, it's deleted.
What's my next event?
Next up, you have Coffee with Mark on Friday at 10 a.m.
Add an event to my calendar.
What's the title of the event?
Meet Madeline.
Sure, when is the event?
Tomorrow at 9 a.m.
All right, meet Madeline tomorrow at 9 a.m.
Create an event for Thursday night at 8 p.m.
What's the title of the event?
Meet Alan.
Sure, meet Alan on Thursday at 8 p.m. Do you want to save that?
Yes. All right, now I know that situation is not perfect and it's not what everyone is looking for in terms of synchronization capability. The truth is you cannot delete events from an external service on either calendar, either Google or iOS calendar. Neither of them will allow an external service to come in, delete an event, and that's why we can't create the perfect synchronization here. So ultimately, where does this leave you? The ability to use one of your applications, that you can go ahead and do that, but if you use iOS and you delete an event in iOS, you're going to have to delete the event on Google Calendar as well. So that becomes a bit of a pain of management. The other situation is you could just use Google Calendar. And what that eliminates for you is the ability of some of the inherent integration for the iOS calendar. So what I'll tell you is that you will have to add events to, you know, using your Google Home or the Google Assistant to the Google Calendar or the Google Calendar application. You'll have to add events there going forward. That's kind of what I suggest for people with iOS or iPhones at this point, is just use the Google Calendar application to manage all of your events and just stop using the iOS calendar. The only people that I think that's really going to impact are people who use Siri on a regular basis to add events to their calendar. So if you're really bought into your Google Home or your Google Assistant, go ahead, use the Google Calendar instead of creating the synchronization I've shown you, or go ahead and do that. If you don't remove a lot of events, this isn't going to be a big problem for you, and this synchronization will be good for you. Now, one thing obviously for you all, if you wanted, you could go and create an if this then that applet that would synchronize. If you created events more often in iOS, you could actually do the reverse of what I just did. So you could create a trigger from creating a calendar event in iOS and have that action be in your Google Calendar. So if you're more likely to use your phone to create calendar events, that's a good option for you to go ahead and synchronize those calendars to get those events here. Now, keep in mind, if you do that and you also synchronize an event on your Google Calendar, you will create duplicates and it'll go like that, and you'll end up with, I think, 4 events in the end, or 3 at the very least. So keep that in mind. You only want that add event to happen in one direction between these two applications. So there you have it, everyone. Now, obviously, I've given you how to set up your iOS device and synchronize these calendars as best as is possible today. But what I'm also trying to do is tell you there's a better way. And you know what? That's what this channel is about. It's about saving you time. So I don't want you actually to synchronize your calendar. I want you to use Google Calendar so that your life has more time in it to do more important things. So there you have it, everyone. Go ahead, click that subscribe button that's coming at the end here so I can share with you more tips and tricks to save time in your life and ultimately automate your life. So thanks for watching, everyone, and we'll see you next time.